Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel, Jennifer Marie, where I teach you different ways that you can make money online as a work from home freelancer. In today's tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to use Upwork's mobile app for freelancers. Upwork has an app especially for freelancers that you can download on your Android or your iPhone. And I'm going to show you how you can do everything on the app, including searching for jobs, applying for jobs, and even signing up and editing your profile. So if you're not familiar with Upwork, I have a complete guide for freelancers. I've earned nearly $100,000 on Upwork since I started as a beginner freelancer a few years ago. I've linked you to this playlist in the description below. But in today's tutorial, I'm going to focus on the freelancer app that you can download on your phone. So if you have an Android or an iPhone, you can go ahead and download this app. It's completely free. So I've opened up Google Play and I'm just going to type in Upwork. You can see here there are two apps, Upwork for freelancers or Upwork for clients. We're going to download Upwork for freelancers. So install the app on your phone. And from here, you can either log into your account if you've already created an account, or if you're new to Upwork, you can click New to Upwork, sign up, and you can create your entire account on the app without having to use your computer. If you want help on how to set up a profile, check out my playlist in the description below to learn about setting up your own profile and getting started. But in this tutorial, we're focusing on navigating the app once you already have an account. So I'm just going to click login and log in with my username and my password. I'm going to click confirm my choices for my privacy preference. And now we are logged in. So first I'm going to show you how you can manage your profile from within the app. If you click on the circular icon on the top left-hand corner, that will open up a menu, and from here you can click Profile. And this shows you your profile that you have created or that you have yet to create. And you can edit every section of your profile by clicking on the pencil icon. So if you haven't created your profile yet, you can go through and fill in all the information. Again, check out my video on how to do this, which I've linked you to in the description below. But if you click on the pencil icon beside View Profile, here you can change your profile visibility. You want to make sure your profile is public if you want people to be able to send you interview requests. You can set your project preference. You can also set your experience level, what category you are interested in working in, and you can add up to two specialized profiles. Let's say you have one as a voiceover artist and another as a video editor. Again, just click any of the pencil icons to make edits, and then let's click on the back arrow to go back. So right here is your title of your profile, and this is basically a single sentence description of your professional skills or experience. In my case, professional voiceover artist. Maybe you're a web designer, video editor, so you can edit your title. You can also edit how much you will charge per hour, and under your hourly rate is the overview section. And here you're going to write a description of the skills and experience you have, essentially what you are able to offer a client. When you're writing this, I recommend you check out other profiles within your niche to get an idea of what other people in your niche are writing in their profiles to inspire you to create your own. So click Save once you're finished that. And if you scroll down, there's a section called Portfolio, and this is an opportunity for you to showcase your work. So let's say you're a YouTube thumbnail designer. You can upload different thumbnails that you have created, samples of your work as a voiceover artist or as a writer, and just click the plus icon to add items to your portfolio. You can also add your skills, the amount of hours per week you are willing to work or open to work, the languages you speak, your education, and any other employment history or information you want to add to your profile. All of this can be edited later. So let's go back. So now let me show you how to search for jobs. At the bottom, click on Jobs, and then here's a search bar, so you can type in whatever kind of job you're looking for. For example, let's type in thumbnail. Let's say you are looking for a job as a thumbnail designer. You can see over 1,400 jobs have popped up, so we want to filter these down to find one that's right for you. So if you click on this icon here, this allows you to filter jobs. So you can filter by the newest jobs, by the experience level, the job type, whether you want an hourly job or a fixed price job, You can filter by number of proposals, and that means how many people have applied to the job so far. You can also select if you want to only look for jobs from clients who are payment verified. I recommend you do this because that way you know a client is serious about hiring someone. You can filter by the budget. And right here, this is really important. It says connects needed. So if you don't know what connects are, you need connects in order to apply for jobs. You only get a certain amount of free connects per month. I believe that is 10 per month. And if you have a Freelancer Plus account, you get 70 connects each month. When you register an account for Upwork for the first time, you do get 40 free connects, and there are different ways to get more connects as well. If you want to purchase connects, they cost 15 cents each. So if you're just starting out, I recommend applying for jobs by filtering down 4 connects or less, and that way you're not wasting all of your connects on applying to one job. And when you're finished, just click Apply Filters, and that will narrow the jobs down even more. And you can go ahead and apply to any of the jobs that you like. So how do you apply for jobs? So when you see a job that you're interested in, just click on it and you can learn more information. You can scroll down and view what they're looking for, what the payment is, and under activity on this job, you can see the number of proposals, so how many people have applied to the job. And if you're interested in the job, just click Apply Now. And applying to a job on Upwork involves submitting a proposal. So you can propose with your general profile that you created, or if you created a specialized profile. If you scroll down under Terms, you can select if you want to be paid the job by milestone or by project. I have videos that go into detail on this, but essentially, milestones are if the client decides to divide the project into smaller segments and you get paid for each segment, or by project, which means you get paid a flat fee for the entire project. Usually, I pick by project, but that can be discussed with a client at a later time. Then you're going to bid, and a bid does not mean money you are spending. It means how much you are willing to do the job for. So if you are willing to do the job for $100, put $100. If it's an hourly rate job, you would put how much your hourly rate is. You have to select how long the project will take as well. And then you have a chance to write a cover letter. Now, Upwork is a little different from applying to a normal job in person. Your cover letter should not be extremely long. I have videos on how to create a cover letter, but essentially you want to introduce yourself briefly, tell them about your experience, and submit samples of your work. If you are applying to be a thumbnail designer, you would tell them about your experience in graphic design, what software programs you use, such as Photoshop, and then you would either send a link to samples of your work or you can attach files as well. There is an option to boost your proposal, but this is optional. And then once you're finished, click Send for 4 connects. And that means you have spent 4 connects of your connect balance to apply to this job. So now I want to show you how you can manage your proposals and your job applications. You can click on Proposals at the bottom, and here you can see any offers you've been sent, any invitations to interview, any active proposals, and submitted proposals. You can also click on Contracts, and this will show you any of your active contracts. And if you want to communicate with your client, you can use the messaging system on the app. And this is great if you are a freelancer and you're on the go, but your client wants to get in touch with you and let's say you're out shopping or you're in town. You can click on messages and this will open up a private message with each of your clients or clients that you are talking about potentially working together. You can also click on alerts at the bottom here, and this is essentially all of your notifications on Upwork. And if you want to adjust any other settings, you can click on your profile picture at the top again. And now let's talk about how to get paid. So click on Settings. At the top it says Billing and Payments, but this is not what you select in order to get paid. This, for example, is if you want to purchase connects to apply for more jobs or subscribe to the Freelancer Plus plan, you can select Billing and Payments. And that is how you will pay for more connects or to be a plus freelancer. Otherwise, click Get Paid. And here you can see your available balance if you have any money that you can withdraw. You can also select your withdrawal schedule to see when you will get paid. You can view your transaction history. And under withdrawal methods, you can add a method of how you prefer to get paid. There are many different ways to do this. You can get paid directly to your local bank, via Payoneer or PayPal, a wire transfer. I recommend signing up to Wise. You can set up a US balance on Wise and get paid US dollars directly into your US balance and then convert that to your own country's currency, and this will help you save on currency conversion fees. I have a tutorial on setting up Wise, which I've also linked you to in the description below. So essentially, this has been an overview of how to use the Freelancer app, and it's an amazing app to use so you can apply to jobs while you're on the go and communicate with your clients so you're never going to miss out on anything. If you have any questions whatsoever about Upwork, feel free to ask me in the comment section of this video. And I have videos on everything you need to know to get started as a freelancer on Upwork. I really recommend you check out my playlist. So thank you guys once again for watching, and I'll see you all in my next tutorial.